It's Wednesday.
What?
We haven't started yet.
Oh.
Now we have.
We have.
I mean, a little bit. We've started a little bit.
So we're starting. We're on.
We're on.
All right. Mike could not make it.
This is true.
But Mike was not the special guest I alluded to.
Uh-huh.
Here in the studio today, I have my fiancé.
In the flesh.
Yes. So this is Karen.
Hi.
She says hello, as you can clearly hear on your own without me saying it.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Jack. There goes the NSA playing us.
Yeah. Oh, yep, see, yep, they...
Yep,
Rich's lady is here. Karen, yes.
She is real.
Yes.
Karen is real. And she's here to bring the mad Dr. Mario skills, because I have none.
You can ask her all of the embarrassing stories about me.
We don't have enough time for all of them.
I am at her mercy right now. So... This is your shot,
Chad. They said Rich is a lady. Oh, this is your alter ego. Am I your alter ego?
Mm-hmm. That could
your
be.
Your other? Yeah, maybe he's got like MDP or
a manifestation.
And I'm really good with changing my voice and talking over myself.
Sure.
We were preparing Dr. Mario because I got a text at like 5:30 this morning. I was just waking up, and I'm sure Rich was just falling asleep.
Yes, that's true.
And,
yes, it's true.
And he says, we need to play Dr. Mario tonight because Mike's coming. And I was like, great. And I get here, and I had all these NES games.
Mm-hmm.
And no Mike, but, I mean, we'll play it again if Mike wants to play
it. Yeah. I texted Mike like 45 minutes before we could start. I'm like, what's going on? You coming? He's like, no, I can't make it. So, no Mike.
And if he likes Dr. Mario, there's Tetris and... Pipe Dream and various other semi-clones. You can do Yoshi's Cookie.
Ooh, Yoshi's Cookie. That's a good game. All right. So, go ahead. Start your inaugural playing.
Rusty, but let's see.
Karen is now playing Dr. Mario.
How do I?
Are you not playing, or this is the menu?
I think you have to press the plus button. We're playing this on my Wii U. There you go.
Okay, so that's the start button.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
How do you play it?
How do you start this?
Just start it at...
Oh, start. What the fuck?
Start it at level one. Do it. That's
I
fine.
I haven't done this in years.
Just no, to get me Rich, warmed up here. Fine.
Well, I know you're good at this. This is like...
But it keeps
this
advancing,
is like
doesn't
Mozart.
It?
He walks out on stage and he starts making fart noises.
Yeah, but when it's done with level one, it'll go up to level two.
Level two's not so hot.
Rich, let her warm up.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sure it's been a long time since she's played Dr. Mario.
It's been years. I don't know why it's been years, why I've neglected Mario for
right.
so long. I'm sure you've missed me.
Oh, here's a good question, Karen. What is your opinion on internet celebrity Rich Evans?
I think it's sort of adorable. when he gets recognized by people, it's cute.
It's
See?
Something.
It's something. Oh, are
but
we
like
quiet?
He said, he'd rather have the fortune than the fame, but he'll take what he can get.
Okay, I've turned all of us up a little bit. Now I've turned us up even more, so we should be significantly louder than the game. If not, let us know. What are we playing? We're playing Dr. Fucking Mario. Come on.
Kicking it old school.
If only the title of the game was on screen right now.
Well, this game is old enough there might be people who don't understand how you play.
Oh, is that true?
That might be true.
I match four horizontally and vertically.
But you gotta eliminate the viruses. The viruses are all colors. There's a blue virus, a red virus,
right. You
a
gotta,
virus.
You gotta make the virus part of a line of four or more.
Yes, and then the virus vanishes with
yes.
the rest of the ones. They're saying it's nice to have you with us.
Oh, it's nice to be here.
What the fuck?
I am real.
She's a good liar.
And polite. It's good to see you, Rich.
Oh, and before we started, that was Dick Neutral that resubscribed, right?
Yeah, we saw the Dick Neutral subscribe. Apparently, Cinnamon just subscribed. Did someone else just subscribe too? Cinnamon, yeah, Cinnamon. thank you both, Dick Neutral and Cinnamon, for resubscribing.
Let's do them separately. Come on. They deserve that
they
much.
They at least deserve their millisecond of fame.
Dick Neutral subscribed before the stream started, and so I was lumping him in with Cinnamon. But Dick Neutral, thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. And Cinnamon, thank you for subscribing.
Is that the dub version of Duke Nukem?
We really appreciate it. Thank you. Oh, and Smorgaslord, apparently. Smorgaslord, thank you for subscribing.
See all these subscribers you're generating, Karen?
These names are nothing if not creative. I'm impressed.
Thank you, Elvis, for pointing out. It's a little strange our setup today. So I'm seeing the chat on my phone, and for some reason it's not telling me when we get a new subscriber.
Are we not hearing it either?
No, we won't be hearing it either, because why won't we be here? We won't be hearing it either. So, okay. If someone subscribes, someone let us know. Smorgaslord, I said it.
What
and
the
I did
fuck?
Update the stream. The stream is updated. Doctor Who, Mario, that's who.
Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for subscribing. We really appreciate it.
Oh, that's really funny.
Karen, what is the funniest thing Rich has ever done in front of you?
Jeez. I played the fifth.
Oh my god, Rich, they're saying
he
that
knows.
Trig Letty Play just uploaded an apology video.
What? His 15 minutes are over.
No, he's trying to stretch it, man.
At this point, it's just attention. Come on. There's nothing to apologize for. It was a comment, and we made fun of it. That's all there is to it. It's not like our feelings were horribly wounded.
Right. Oh, here we go.
You were crying into your...
Right. It's all good. Trig Letty Play.
Right.
It's all good.
Right. Thank you for the URL, Bitly. Is that really... No, is that a subscriber? Did she, the super, just subscribe?
If it didn't, scroll that past where I can see it.
Okay.
You may as well do it anyway. She, the super?
She, the super! If you subscribed, thank you. We very much appreciate it.
If you didn't just subscribe, please disregard this thanks, as you don't deserve it.
To all those out there who did not subscribe, who aren't even hearing our voices.
To all those who aren't even listening to us right now, thank you for not subscribing.
She doesn't have a pizza roll. Ugh.
Oh, that was a ruse? Oh, she the super, you got you. You rascal.
So when you subscribe, you get a pizza roll?
Yeah, you get a little pizza roll picture next to your name. That's what those are. Those are little pizza rolls.
Oh, I thought they were like bathing suits or something.
Bathing suits?
Yeah, they kind of look like One Pieces.
No, I have not faced... Oh, no, yeah, I faced Mega Satan in Binding of Isaac. I got that far before my save was lost. Thanks for bringing that up.
Okay, sure. Karen, so guy... Doctor Killed the Cat. That makes more sense.
That makes way more sense.
Said I already commented on the Next Generation reunion. They want to know what you thought of it.
It was too Shatner heavy. I mean, I guess he wanted to make sure there weren't any awkward silences, but, you know, we came there for the Next Gen reunion, not the William Shatner blowhard thing. I mean, yeah. It was too Shatner heavy and too short, but it was nice to see them all together. I mean, it was, you know, you don't often get to see all of them in the flesh.
How many opportunities are you going to get to have that again?
Yeah. I mean, none of them are kids. And some of them are like Patrick Stewart. I mean, I hope he's around to be 100, but...
He's getting up there.
He's getting up there.
Poor Patrick Stewart. Oh my God.
Pause me or something.
What happened?
I don't know.
Maybe I paused me? I don't... Wait.
Press the one button.
The one button?
Press the one button. There you go. You might have hit it. I don't know.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
shoot.
No.
Yep.
Now I'm having a overdose.
A breakdown.
Yeah, a pill overdose. Mario's having all the side effects that they have on the pharmaceutical commercials.
I can't believe you started on level one.
Warm up, Rich.
Exactly.
Sometimes you gotta warm up.
It was a warm up.
Okay.
Ooh, Jack's snack tonight is water. I'm not snacking tonight. Ooh, Elvis Delvis says he had a huge run, a 90-plus minute run of Risk of Rain today.
Ooh, nice.
Oh, and he was just about to beat the last level of the game, and it froze and crashed on him. I'm so sorry, Elvis.
Ow.
I'm very, very sorry. That happens sometimes, unfortunately. No, these aren't cartridges. These are Wii U virtual console titles.
But they look identical.
Drink harder, Jack. No, I'm not drinking tonight. I gotta drive home. You get drunk, Jack, when I'm already at home. Well, thank you for smoking a huge blunt for me. I appreciate that.
The chat is asking, do I leave the toilet seat up?
What? Can you believe it?
Sure.
More, I do, okay.
More importantly, does Karen leave the toilet seat down?
Yeah.
Let's be equal
fair
opportunity.
Fair is fair.
Yeah.
Fair is fair.
That's never really been my pet battle. We all have our pet battles. I don't really care too much about that one.
It's more important fish to fry?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Your brain cannot wrap itself around this Dr. Mario, right? It's so crazy. You get pills and you have to line up all the colors.
Yes, it's entirely responsible for the drug epidemic of the 1990s. We all spent our childhoods playing with little capsules.
It's true. So many pills. So many pills. No, we're not gonna answer too many awkward questions.
Do I snore?
Yes. Not terribly.
You're not gonna elaborate on that? You're just gonna say yes.
Yes.
Not theatrically. Yeah.
Is it like a bass tone to it, or is it a nasally kind of?
Oh, God.
No, I'm not really too much of that. More of a nose breather, you know, the Darth Vader kind of thing.
Oh, Jesus.
So that's more of the treble, I guess.
Yes, we are going to play more adventure games.
Oh, I hope I'm not too much trouble.
I thought about making that, but that's even bad for me. And I make some pretty bad ones sometimes. Puns, I mean. Shoot.
Okay. What are you
doing? Shizotron?
Great question.
This is apparently Shizotron's fourth month subscribing. Thank you, Shizotron. We very much appreciate it.
We're getting the old timers.
Yeah. Ooh, Waffle Tail. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. Also, thank you to everyone telling me when people subscribe. I really appreciate that. Ooh, see, I think that's a very interesting question, Cinnamon. Is Karen, has your family ever seen any of Rich's videos, and what do they think of that?
You know, I don't think they have. I don't think that they would know what to make of them. My father might find the absurdity, he's a Python fan, he might find the absurdity amusing. My mother would just be confused. Really confused. She'd just kind of nod and smile and suggest we do something else. Yeah.
Do we have to watch this whole video?
Yeah.
I mean, I know Rich is in it, but...
Yeah. Why are you doing that? Why is he... Okay. Oh. Is this one of those things? Yeah.
Pinko Jones! Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. That's my subscriber voice today.
I can tell.
Do you like that?
I can tell.
Do you like it?
It sounds like, what does it sound like?
I'm kind of going for a drunk Walter Cronkite.
It kind of sounds like the before picture in a cold medicine commercial.
Ooh, I like that.
I'm so stuffed. Oh, I can't sleep. And then they take, you know.
I like it.
Whatever. Dan Rather.
Do you think this is like a drunk Dan Rather?
If you really want to be classy, you have to do Bill Curtis.
I don't know if I know Bill Curtis.
Yeah.
He was on Chicago News for years, and then he did some stuff for Annie.
Oh, okay.
Very proper the way he talked.
Got that Midland accent thing, or whatever the heck it was.
Yeah, it's a little Brian Butterfield. Brian Butterfield.
Brian Butterfield.
The Butterfield diet?
Yeah.
I love that.
And you can eat bun buns.
Yeah. For 24 hours. He's eating, like, ice cubes with, like, Crystal Light powder or something the rest of the week. It's awesome.
No, and we are not... For anyone who doesn't know, B-Fest is this weekend.
What's a
B-Fest? B-Fest is the most amazing thing in the world. It is...
B-Fest or B-Fest?
B-Fest.
You would hate it.
24 hours straight of bad movies. Back to back for 24 hours of nothing but bad movies.
Why do you think I would hate it?
You don't like bad movies.
Depends.
For the most part.
It's their first fight.
I made her watch The Room once. She hated
me. Yeah, it wasn't my thing.
And it's over. It's down at Northwestern University. I went last year and had an absolute blast. Jay goes often. I think... I want to say...
What did you do?
I screwed up.
I know you did. Okay, sorry. Go ahead. B-Fest.
No, that's fine. I was right in the middle of my B-Fest story. And Rich... I mean, you know, Karen's here, so I get it. I'm third wheel tonight, and that's fine.
It's okay, Jack. We're sorry. We didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
It's all right. I do believe Josh is going down to B-Fest this year. I can't go, unfortunately. Some work came up, so I cannot go down this year, unfortunately, and I don't know who else is going. But
is this like Svengoolie movies or something?
Whoa, worse.
Worse than Svengoolie movies.
It's beautiful. What was there last year? Megaforce was there last year.
Is there anybody like commenting on them? Like MST3?
No one commenting, but it's, you know, it's live theater, so it's very midnight showing. People yell stuff at the screen. They show Plan 9 from Outer Space every year.
So it's like Rocky Horror Picture Show kind of thing?
It's like Rocky Horror Picture Show, though, but you don't know what movie it is.
Neither do the people in it.
Right? It's so great. I was really upset that I couldn't make it this year. Hopefully I can make it next year.
Sounds abysmal.
It's a little abysmal. It's a little abysmal, but that's kind of what makes it joyful as well. Like, you know, it's 4 in the morning and you've been watching B-movies for 12 straight hours and there's another 12 hours of B-movies happening and you just kind of get lost in this haze.
Oh my God.
It's really beautiful. It may be in Milwaukee next January. That would be amazing.
Karen has never played FTL.
Faster than light. I've seen you play it.
Oh, yeah. Of course you have. It'd be hard not to.
True. I'm more of a The Sims, Roller Coaster Tycoon, casual games.
Here's a very important question, Karen.
Kind of stuff.
Team Edward or Team Jacob?
Oh, I haven't seen any of those, and not really itching to either.
That was the correct answer, thank you. You know, I don't know if you can bring like liquor or beer into B-Fest. Also, you probably just don't want to because the you're trying to stay awake for all of B-Fest, and so anyone who brings in liquor or beer will probably just fall asleep. You want to bring energy drinks.
Is this like a form of self-flagellation? Like wearing a hair shirt? Taking energy drinks and making yourself watch bad movies?
I've never heard the word flagellation before.
That's where the... That's where the... they used to whip themselves as like penance to try to like drive away the Black Plague or something?
Yes, it's a little bit of that.
I'm not gonna lose my Mario game.
Karen was making the whipping gesture, and so she took her hand off the controller.
Completely lost track of what I was doing. So
I was
trying to explain.
I was watching it happen and smiling.
The Schadenfreude. It's like your favorite word, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a good word.
What does Schadenfreude mean, Rich?
The joy in the suffering of others. You're glad to see somebody who's miserable. It's a very honest emotion. I appreciate that.
A universal emotion.
Dr. Kill the Cat says he's been playing FTL for over 50 hours and he still hasn't won yet.
Really?
On easy.
Well, maybe the problem is you.
Even I won, and you know how terrible I am at games.
Yeah, maybe you should take something else up.
You know, I look up some strategies. It got significantly easier once Rich started explaining the use of the teleporters. Try out different strategies.
Yeah. Because whatever you're doing, it's not working.
Clearly.
Yeah. The real Netboy, I've just said your name. Thank you for subscribing. I don't know if you just subscribed or if you are an old subscriber, but in any case, I appreciate it. He just wanted me to say his name.
Okay.
So I did.
That's all right. They just like us that much.
I think it's great.
What a likable guy.
Is Karen impressed with your new PC, Rich?
It boots up very fast. Well, that's not a double entente. No, it could be, I guess.
Oh no!
I haven't seen too much of it yet because it's really new. I haven't gotten a chance to check out all of its bells and whistles. But yeah, it boots up very quick. I'm thinking I should probably look into adopting some of that setup for mine.
Another live PC build right here on Previously Recorded.
Rich builds his fiance's computer.
Right.
Oh, you guys built his computer on here?
On air. Yep.
That's cool. So they know you got that solid state thing going and everything?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, not only did they know, they had to convince him.
That was an issue.
They had to convince
him
to get it, yeah.
Yeah, but isn't that what makes it boot up so fast? Or
yeah.
That's the flag.
Sure. The question was, were there more efficient things to do with it? That was the question.
Ah, so they were debating on, like, what's the, whether more RAM or more.
Kind of.
Or
yeah.
This or that
yeah.
would be.
Spend more money on a larger processor, you know.
Yeah. And was the consensus that this was the way to go?
Everyone,
Or did everyone have a different opinion?
Most people.
Rich had a different opinion.
The mechanical hard drive.
Yeah.
I eventually broke down.
The mechanical hard drive.
I mean, the
solid
yes,
state hard
drive.
I've never played NetHack. Rich, have you played NetHack?
No.
I've never played NetHack. I'm sorry.
Is that where you hack the net?
It's apparently where you hack the net.
Let's see, Rich, Karen knows your shit.
Right, Karen knows. That was a weird stream. I felt weird about like just watching Rich build a PC. We had classical music playing in the background. It was
oh no.
Oh.
Oh, fatal mistake.
You should have.
I'm embarrassed. I'm playing before millions of your fans.
It's fine.
I used to be really good at this.
You can't let that get to you. You can't let that get to you.
Mm-hmm.
I used to be really good at this.
I'm sure you're still really good. Acquainting yourself.
Exactly.
And slightly distracted to first.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I should stop talking to anyone and give my full attention to Mario.
People are asking about Jay's vlog. I subscribed after he started the vlog. I love it. I love hearing Jay's opinions on the world, and I think it's really great for him to have this outlet where he can just kind of talk about whatever, you know, like what's happening in the day. I think Jay's vlog is great.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah. No, I don't think Jay's coming around tonight either. They must be working on something super secret and special. Or it's another episode of one of the shows that you already know. But.
You guys like episodes of things, right? I mean,
it's been a while.
Yeah.
Well, not really a while. They had a...
We had a Christmas bonanza.
We did. We had a late December glut.
It worked out that way.
No, Jay doesn't have a blog. He has a vlog. Or a vlog. I've heard it pronounced both ways.
If you're going to call blogs blogs, you shouldn't call a vlog a vlog. That's just weird.
I agree.
It's almost like that argument we have about whether it's NES or NES.
Mm. Oh, probably both.
See, I've always called it the NES. It's, you know.
Well, it is, I mean, right.
You know what? I'll say NES, but I'll call the Super Nintendo the SNES. I'll have it both ways.
Yeah, I think you can. I think it's tomato tomato. You're right, A Horrible Glory. Jay does feel like he's more relatable now that he's vlogging. He's just a real person. The super. I would appreciate it if you found me attractive. I cannot promise I'll play NetHack. We'll try. Listen, we need games to play all the time on the stream. So, listen, you don't need to subscribe. You can just say I want you to play NetHack. What is NetHack?
I don't know.
We don't even know what it is. What system is it on? Is it a CompuTrader game? Or is it one of them consoles?
I have to imagine that you hacked the net at some point in that game.
I would only assume you'd hack the net.
I don't know why you need to hack the net. I'm assuming there's a reason in the game.
I mean,
so you have an axe and you go after a net and you free all the fish? Is it a fishing game?
Oh, maybe that's it. Maybe it's like a Greenpeace. Like, yeah. Free the whales, hack the net.
It's sponsored by PETA.
I love it. Yeah. I love it.
Fish are friends, not food.
It's true.
You're a sweetheart.
Oh, NetHack is a real quote-unquote roguelike.
The real one.
Unlike
well, we've
all
been
of
playing
the fake
all
ones.
Those fake ones, so.
Yeah.
Is it real with two E's? Are we still talking about fishing?
No.
Oh.
Ooh, I did have more time to play Swapper, and it's definitely Swapper was a bad choice for streaming, but playing it by myself, I really did enjoy it. So, I've been playing a little more Swapper, and I've been playing a little more Call of Duty.
Really?
Yeah, and you know what's terrible? Call of Duty.
Why have you been playing more of it?
Research. Rich, I have been meticulously researching our next episode. Do you know what's a really boring topic?
Call of Duty?
Willful suspension of disbelief. The papers that are out there on the willful suspension of disbelief are incredibly boring. When people start talking about the science behind our imagination, it gets really boring. So...
just observe it and see if it works for you. That's all you need to do. That's all you need to do.
I've gotten enough Call of Duty playtime in where now I'm okay never playing Call of Duty again.
See, I think as far as our topic goes, all I need to know about Call of Duty is that infamous scene.
Yes. Sure. I wanted to get a little more just for general reference. Just for general reference. Bill LaHecka, this is Karen with us today.
Hi.
What does somebody think? It's Jesse? I'm waiting for that to happen.
Oh, sure.
I'm waiting for somebody to ask Jesse a question.
and for those asking, I was playing the new Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. And it was terrible.
For people showing up late, I am sitting next to my fiancé.
Hi.
It's true.
In the flesh. playing Dr. Mario.
This is everything you imagine the night would be.
Right.
It's a fine way to spend an evening.
Oh, Rich, let's play Dr. Mario.
So many places I could go with that, and I'm gonna go to none of them.
Are we ridiculously quiet? I'm hearing that we are ridiculously quiet tonight. Hold on.
Like volume-wise?
Volume-wise. I am now adjusting our volume. Alright, talk, guys.
Hello?
Testing? What?
Testing. 1, 2, 3. How about this?
Almost had it.
But now the volume is up enough where you guys might not want to yell.
Okay.
That would be bad. Dr. Vector, that's not how you spell Jesse. Yes. Ooh, yeah. And someone did gift me Spec Op the Line, and I'm interested in playing that. Much better. Okay, great, Octo-J. Great. Audio was fine before. Oh, God. Well, if it's still fine now, then that's all that really matters.
So, Jack.
Yeah, Rich.
Something I was talking about with people in the chat before.
Okay.
I started streaming.
Mm-hmm.
Where is Harrison Ford without Indiana Jones? Was Star Wars enough for Harrison Ford to be a star, or would he have just been the Han Solo guy without Indiana Jones?
100% the Han Solo guy, because that's what everyone else in that movie was. 100%.
Karen, I know you probably don't care as much, but what do you think?
Well, he would have been the Han Solo guy, but that is enough. I mean, there are a lot of hardcore Star Wars fans.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You could easily...
But would he be starring in a ton of other movies, is the question. Or would he just be signing his autograph at conventions and making his living as the Han Solo guy and not as Harrison Ford megastar actor?
No, I think if he wasn't Indiana Jones, he would have been something else.
Yep.
I think he would have gotten roles.
Okay. Because he struggled before Indiana Jones. Like, was in some movies that failed.
No, because right before Star Wars, right... Ooh, hold on.
Name me a Harrison Ford movie between Star Wars and Indiana Jones. Well, again, I guess it's only
like
a
that
few
many years.
Years.
Yeah,
no, but I mean, you know, he went right from American Graffiti into Star Wars, and then the rest is history. The rest.
What was it like? What's the first Star Wars movie now? Like 35 years old?
Oh, Jesus, right.
I can't talk, do the math, and play Dr. Mario at the same time. It's like 77 or something.
It was 77.
Oh, my God.
It's exactly as old as I am.
Blade Runner wasn't in between those two. Or
no,
that's later.
A little bit after. Blade Runner was...
90, maybe?
Maybe it was.
I don't know. Witness. Hell yeah, Witness.
No, wait, I'm going to say Blade Runner.
The Amish kid?
Witness.
Is Harrison Ford in that? Man, I haven't seen
him
in so many years.
Witness is great.
Blade Runner 82, I'm going to say.
Okay. I'd believe that. I don't know the correct answer. How about that?
Indy J would have been 81.
Raiders was 80.
Jeez, it's not like we could look it up on Wikipedia or anything.
We actually can't.
Could on the tablet, but yeah. You can only rub your belly and scratch your nose and do so many things at once. Technology's
right
there. We just need better partitioned minds.
Is that true? Was Blade Runner a flop?
I think it was.
In the theaters?
It was a critical hit, because, you know, it looked so good.
Yeah. But it was an actual flop?
I want to say yes.
Oh, man, that's terrible.
I don't know that I'd say that was terrible.
I mean, it's terrible.
It's what it was.
It's terrible when good movies flop.
Well, Fight Club
that
was a flop.
Was it really?
Yeah.
Did it get a resurgence in the DVD
really?
Market?
I'm pretty sure. I'll look it up, but if, as I recall, Fight Club did not do well when it came out.
Huh.
It was kind of a sleeper hit, or whatever you want to call it.
Sleeper hit, yeah.
Well, you know... What are you doing? Oh,
I have
God.
No idea.
Oh, my God. Get the blue one down. And no, oh, my God, that ruins everything. Oh, no.
It doesn't ruin anything. I'll get it.
Blade Runner was ahead of its time, so of course it was a flop. Absolutely. Absolutely. Oh, apparently Blade Runner was a flop, but then it was re-released in the 90s, and it
what the
became
fuck?
A cult sensation.
The book is awesome. Do androids dream of electric sheep?
Chris Newlin! Thank you for subscribing. We really appreciate it.
Oh, they're saying Fight Club did $100 million, so I don't think that was a flop.
I could be wrong.
Well, what was its budget?
$800 million.
Seriously?
No, no.
Oh. You're going for a second.
I made up that number. Aha.
You just gotta get the red thing on there. You just need one red thing.
I know. I need. Oh, here we go. Right there. It's here.
Okay.
Because when this goes here, the nose will fall. And
there you go.
Boom.
There you
level
go.
9. Finally. Finally completed. On to level next.
Yep, sorry, I was not expecting super laughter. Apologies to everyone's ears. That's another thing I need to figure out, is like...
What happened?
I need a limiter, is what I need.
Did I break somebody's
ear? You broke everyone's ears, but that's okay.
What did I laugh at?
I don't know.
Don't you remember?
I didn't even remember. Where did I laugh at?
I don't know, someone said something funny.
Got like amnesia?
No, I think so. I don't remember what I was laughing at, so amnesia.
So amnesia.
That's how it works.
Is it? Is it?
Just tell him it is. We don't want to upset him.
Oh, what's the, by the way, speaking of Philip K. Dick.
Yeah, he's the author of Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep?
And he's also the author of...
Total Recall, which was called something crazy.
No, and recently it's Amazon Prime pilot season,
mm-hmm.
where Amazon Prime tries to shove out a whole bunch of original content. You get to vote on which they produce.
Okay.
And they just produced a Philip K. Dick adaptation. Oh, what is it called? The Men Who Live in Castles, or...
Okay.
And that's a Philip K. About? So there's an Amazon original series based on a Philip K. Dick novel.
Ooh, thank you, Bitly. Man in the High Castle. Yeah.
I gotta check that out.
It's actually... The pilot was super amazing, and if you have Amazon Prime, you can see the pilot now.
You're very quick to point that out. I do.
I totally want to check that out.
It's a really good... Basically, it's what if the Nazis and Japan had won World War II?
Huh.
And taken over America.
So it's like wacky revisionist history, like that Inglourious Basterds, except like the dystopian version.
Exactly, and it's awesome. I really enjoyed it. It's only the pilot, so it's only one episode, but I really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you, Tyrone, for pointing that out. And produced by Ridley Scott.
He likes him some Philip K. Dick.
Honestly, I think
does he have Radiohead doing the soundtrack? Because supposedly their OK Computer album was heavily influenced by Philip K. Dick's work. Mm.
Ooh. Oh,
I don't
watch game.
It's true. It was very nice. Read the novel. Okay. I will, A Horrible Glory. I've been looking for a new book to read. And it sounds like this Philip K. Dick guy, he might have it together. I think he's a new up-and-coming... Right. Yeah. Yep. Jack don't got cable. I don't have cable. I only have... I have the Amazon and I have the Netflix.
I don't either. I don't miss it.
No, you don't need it. You don't need
it. Every now and then there's a sports game that I can't watch. But other than that...
But you don't miss watching endless commercials for pharmaceuticals and lawsuits involving pharmaceuticals?
Nice.
Take such and such. It'll change your life. If you took such and such, you may be eligible to be part of a lawsuit.
Speaking of sporting events,
mm-hmm.
how about them Packers?
I hear they play the ball of foot. I also hear they're not in the World Series of football this year.
They didn't score as many runs as that other team.
Yeah.
See, Chad, this is why I can't talk about this. Nobody in this room, other than me, gives a shit.
Mm-hmm. About football?
Generally, I don't give a shit about football, but I do hate the Packers.
Well, they're not in it, though.
I know, and it was delightful. They kind of choked.
Isn't it this year, the Patriots and somebody?
It's somebody and also another team. Usually that's how the Super Bowl works.
Two teams and one will lose.
The Patriots and the team that beat the Packers.
Yeah. It wasn't the Ravens. It was somebody else.
Who was it?
Last year. I don't remember. Somebody just told me.
Was it the Rams? No, Seahawks.
Maybe the Rams.
It was Seattle.
Yeah, it's the Seahawks. Right.
Was it the Seahawk Rams?
See, but what you might not understand, Jack.
The Sea Rams?
That would make a great, like a dolphin with a ram with ram's horns would be like an awesome
narwhal. The Seattle Narwhals.
Yeah, I would totally get their merchandise just because it was wacky. You know, like the Lansing Lugnuts baseball team or something.
What?
That's totally...
Is that a real team?
Yeah, they're minor league. A lot of the minor league teams like to go with the really strange and silly names.
And they're called the Lansing Lugnuts. I think that's great.
There's another team, Montgomery or something, the Biscuits. Mm.
The Biscuits! They're my favorite team.
See, you don't care about football, so you don't give a shit one way or the other, but me?
Yeah.
I take a lot of shit from Mike and Jay and Jesse and everybody who lives around here who are Packers fans. Because I'm from Chicago, and I somewhat casually root for the Bears.
Sure, sure.
And so I took so much delight in their misery. Let's bring it all back to Schadenfreude.
Okay.
And just watching the Packers fail as amazingly spectacularly as they failed.
Just because he's tired of hearing all that shit.
Just because I'm tired of hearing all that shit. It was a wonderful evening for me when I went home that night and I started watching the highlights on the internet and the interwebs, and God, was I laughing. I said, oh my God, from the stream at 1 a.m. and I'm sure my neighbors were trying to sleep and they heard this cackling coming from my apartment.
That's great. I had a slight, hold on, there we go. I had a slight invested interest because of a couple of videos that I'm making revolving the Super Bowl, and so it would have worked out better business wise if the Packers would have won.
Okay.
And so I was driving back from Minnesota that day, and so I was like, every once in a while I was checking the score on my phone, and it got to the start of the fourth quarter, and the Packers were winning like 16-0. Yeah. It's like, oh great, this is
good for business.
This is good for business. And then all of a sudden, I get home and they've lost.
They lost in like the last minute or something.
The last 1 minute, and it's how as a professional sports team, how do you do that?
Well, it's like the Cubs when they a few years back, the Chicago Cubs. Everybody thought, oh, they're finally going to win the Super Bowl. They had the best record in the National League. And all the all the Cubs fans were like, oh, they're gonna win, and then they got swept out of the playoffs, completely.
That's terrible.
See, I thought you were talking about the Bartman incident.
Oh no, that was a different year. The Bartman incident was like in 2003 or something. I don't know. I don't think they're ever gonna win it. I don't really care.
Space Kamal, I'm glad that you're listening to Bjork. You should.
Oh, Bjork's awesome.
Bjork's wonderful.
Would you care to talk about Bjork?
I haven't followed her most recent stuff, but I liked Selma's songs and her early stuff. And she's just weird and wacky and Icelandic and fun.
Apparently her new album, even though it's not supposed to come out for a couple months, released on the UK's iTunes, like months ahead of time, unannounced. And all of a sudden it's just like, there it is. There's Bjork.
Huh.
We can't get it yet.
I'll have to try and sample it somewhere. I'm sure they have, somewhere you can download a track or two of it.
I'm sure. Elvis Delvis is saying that the Seahawks scored 15 points in 44 seconds. And I don't know much about football, but I would think that you couldn't do that.
They had like a field goal and a touchdown or something.
You know what that's called? Hmm. Snatching defeat from the jaws of victory.
Yeah. That's called an epic, what do they call that? The choke.
A choke. Yeah.
I'm sure their fans were heartbroken, but I'm not one of them, so.
I walked into the studio on Monday, mm-hmm. right after the game, you know, that Monday.
Yeah.
And Mike just points to me and he says, "Don't you say anything. Don't you say anything."
You just smile.
After giving me shit all year, he says, "Don't you say anything." So you know what I did?
Huh.
I said, "Oh, I won't say anything. I'll talk about something else." You know, I was at a restaurant before I came here today, mm-hmm. and you know, I was getting down to like the last quarter of my sandwich, and I just started choking. That's a good thing. There was a doctor right next to me. Somebody across the room threw a first aid kit at him, and for some reason, I just jumped up to try and grab it, and it bounced off of my head.
Did it bounce? Something bounced off somebody's head in that game, like Jose Canseco style.
One of the player who wasn't supposed to go for the ball foolishly tried to go for it. One of the Packers players, and it bounced off of his head and went right into the hands of a Seahawks player.
Oh my god. I did see.
He's never going to live that down.
No, he's
going to be like Jose Canseco, right? The baseball player.
For him. But that wasn't like in a playoff game.
Okay, true.
Jose Canseco went up to grab a deep
fly
ball.
He was in the outfield.
And instead of catching it, it bounced off his head. And because it bounced off his head, it bounced over the fence. It was a home run.
Yeah. It was not one of the man's finer moments. It gets replayed in every blooper reel forever. He will never live it down.
That's really funny. Alright, Gobbledygooks. Gobbledygooks wants to know, Karen, favorite Julia Roberts movie, Pretty Woman or Runaway Bride?
I've never seen Runaway Bride.
Okay.
So I guess it has to be Pretty Woman. I remember liking it when it came out.
The better question is, how do you feel about Julia Roberts? I think they expect you to like the chick flicks.
Do you think that she's still America's sweetheart? Or do you think that she jumped the shark after Love, Eat, Pray?
Or do you care?
I think the world has forgotten about her, possibly because she's no longer young. I don't know. She used to be really popular and really well-known, and now you never really hear about her. Not that I really watch a whole lot of, you know, Lifetime Channel or something where they'd probably talk about her, but she used to not be able to, you know, leave the house or turn on the TV without hearing the words Julia Roberts.
Mm.
And that's not really the case anymore, for whatever reason.
Hmm. I think she just gets tired.
Or maybe she just figures she's got enough money that she doesn't have to really work anymore, and she'll just, you know, maybe she's adopting, you know, pandas in Angola or whatever.
Is that something you can do?
You can do anything if you've got enough money.
I can do that.
Karen, what is your favorite movie?
My favorite movie?
Oh my god.
Oh, this required a pause.
It does. Shoot. I'm sure I've got one. I don't know. But just pass for right now. I'll try to think.
Okay, that's fine.
And you know, it doesn't have to be of all time. Just the favorite movie you've seen recently, your favorite movie at the time.
What's the first thing that comes to your head?
Paranorman. Paranorman was adorable.
Paranorman was adorable.
I like a lot of, you know, kids movies like Monster House. The Lego Movie was really cute.
Mm-hmm.
I like Fight Club.
Fight Club. I love Fight Club. I like Big Hero 6.
Mm-hmm.
Still haven't seen the Hobbit movie yet. I like the first two of them. Yeah, I know I'm missing something, but
that's fine. That's
fine.
It's not like you're gonna be quizzed.
Yeah,
Paranorman's good. I really like. It's. I think it's hard to do kind of like spooky kids movies, and I think they got the balance just right.
Yeah.
Zombies. Kids movie with zombies and ghosts. It's fun.
And a blatantly gay man.
Yeah, that. Well, it wasn't. You know, it wasn't blatant. It was subtle. You know, where he just said, you know, "You're gonna love my boyfriend." And I thought that was a nice touch. Yeah, the main girl in the movie.
Oh yeah, the love interest.
She had the hats on for the good looking guy.
The
and
jock.
Yeah, the jock. Right, but it turned out the jock. She wants to go see a movie with the jock, so the jock's like, sure, we'll take my boyfriend too. He loves chick flicks.
Oh, that's great. I remember now. I've only seen it once. All I'm looking to see now is the Box Trolls. I've heard great things about the Box Trolls.
I wanted to see it. Mm. Oh, and the Book of Life. The one with the Mexican Day of the Dead kind of thing that came out around Halloween last year. That's a gorgeous movie.
I don't even know if I've heard of that.
Yeah, it's the Day of the Dead with the sugar skulls.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, like when they're in the underworld, dead world, they're the sugar skulls. Otherwise, they're like these little Mexican wood carved like retablo kind of people. And it's a love story, and it's animated, it's CGI, but it all looks like it's made out of wood or clay.
Oh, that's great.
And it's really fun. And it's gorgeous.
That's great.
Were you fond of the Life of Pi movie, or did you just like the book?
Me?
Yeah.
I haven't actually seen the Life of Pi movie, although I've been meaning to. I did like the book.
I know you read the book.
Yeah. I'm wondering how they handled that, because, I mean, it's pretty graphic, I think the tiger ate his mother. How do they... Do they show that? Do they just allude to it? I'm wondering if they just suddenly flash back and show the gory version of it. Or if they just don't. I don't know. Because I haven't seen it, I really can't say. But I could see where that could potentially be, like, pretty disturbing to actually see it.
Maybe some of that. Life of Pi.
And then I figure you're looking forward to The Martian.
The guy on Stranded on Mars?
Oh, yeah, the Andy Weir book. I loved that book.
What is it called? The Martians?
It's about
Explain
this...
Explain the book. Advertise
well,
the book.
It's a book by Andy Weir, like W-E-I-R or W-I-E-R.
Do you want me to play while you talk?
Yeah, why don't you play while I talk? It's a book. It's a hard sci-fi book, you know, like a relatively accurate to science kind of
sure,
book.
Sure, sure.
And this guy's an astronaut, and they have some bad weather on Mars. It's a Mars probe, and they send people to Mars in the relatively near future.
Okay.
And... there's a storm, there's bad weather, and they have to evacuate. And this guy, he gets separated from the other people, and they think he's dead. Mm-hmm. But he's not dead. Mm-hmm.
Don't get into spoilers.
Yeah, well, he has to find a way to let people on Earth know that he's not dead and to stay alive until they can come back and try to get him.
Ooh, it sounds great.
Because their ship is heading back to Earth. And they're supposed to be making a movie out of it, and I'm totally looking forward to it.
Nice. Yeah, that sounds great.
It's a great book. I highly recommend
it. You can plug things you like here, and maybe get a business.
Should we plug Off to Be the Wizard?
If you want to,
Rich
sure.
And I love that. It's comedy. I can't think of who wrote it off the top of my head. What was the sequel called? Do you remember? To Be the Wizard and...
some kind of plot.
Atlantis something. It's... humor sci-fi.
Some kind of pun. I forgot what
the guy
was.
Isn't the guy who does like XKCD or whatever?
I don't think it's that strip. It's another strip. He's got some kind of web comic that he does.
Everybody has a web comic.
Yeah. Yeah, I love that, and I love
Speller High Water.
Speller High Water. That was it. And I still got to get you to read Robert Cruzy's Disenchanted.
Mm-hmm. It's another one you've been trying to sell me on.
I try to sell everybody on that. It's they're both, you know, lighthearted humor.
The book about the guy who gets trapped on Mars is called The Martian. Mm-hmm. They said you're throwing out too many names at once.
The Martian, sorry. This is my first time doing this. The Martian is by Andy Weir. It's W-I-E-R, W-E-I-R, one of those. Off to Be the Wizard and Speller High Water. I can't... Is it Martin, the guy's last name?
That's the character's name.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Those are by the same author, and Disenchanted's by Robert Kroese.
Oh, I should have done that. Oh, well. Yeah. Everything worked out just fine.
Oh, they're saying that Ridley Scott is making The Martian. Ridley Scott does
Ridley
everything.
Scott is making The Martian.
He does everything.
Holy fuck.
Who's Ridley Scott?
Oh, God. Oh, God.
I'm sure I've seen things.
Alien.
Oh, okay.
Blade Runner.
Oh, God. Okay, yeah.
Gladiator.
Just a couple of
movies. Just a couple minor movies.
No, you know what? It's no big deal. Don't worry about it.
I didn't know Ridley Scott was attached.
The book was like self-published, and he actually did open sourced the information out to people so that they could fact check it. So science geeks could tell him, you kind of got that wrong, and maybe this would have been this. And,
that's great.
And tried to make the math real accurate and everything, and then it got picked up by a publisher, and now they're going to make a movie out of it. It's a little Cinderella story.
I think that's beautiful. I think that's beautiful. Rich is playing now, and I don't know.
Book talk.
I don't know who's. I haven't been actually watching, so I don't know who's been doing better. Let's just say Karen has, because maybe that'll.
That's fine.
That'll be funny.
Oh, it's a contest.
Does this have two-player mode?
It does have two.
The Dr. Mario.
Do we have a second controller?
Yeah, we have a second controller.
Okay. I'm gonna play a little bit, and I'm gonna call you out. We're gonna have a showdown.
Did what?
No.
We did what now?
Everything's fine.
Taco.
She's taking a bathroom break.
We've had the alien versus aliens discussion before. They're two different movies, and they're both good in very different ways.
Yes.
It depends on which type of movie you like better.
I personally love Aliens, but that doesn't mean I can't recognize that Alien is a good movie.
Right.
I just prefer the other. But I'm more of an action and adventure guy than a horror guy.
Exactly. I see this is now going to turn into divorce the stream, because you're about to challenge Karen at Dr. Mario. So, the couch that we're sitting on right now, this is where Rich is going to sleep tonight, which is great. And, I think it's fine. It's a comfy couch, so I think it'll be fine.
The big comfy couch. Wasn't
that
a TV show?
They're what are they calling this again, Jack?
Divorce the stream.
Divorce the stream? Divorce.
You
didn't.
It's fine. But be ultra careful.
They're saying that Simon.
No, I can't.
Talking about now, chat? You've lost me. The chat just they get on their own special tangents.
Yeah.
And it takes me a while to catch up to it. There's a lot of Paxton talk, a lot of Bill Paxton talk.
Game over, man. Game over.
Is he the coach for the Packers or something?
No. He is what is called an actor.
Mm-hmm. He acts in movies professionally. He plays pretend in front of a camera professionally.
And he was in the movie Aliens.
Aliens. He's also been in several other movies. Most notably, you might recognize him from a movie called Twister, opposite Helen Hunt.
I'd say most notably Aliens.
Bill Pac-Man?
No, Twister was,
most notably Aliens!
Aliens was a bigger movie, but he was the lead in
so
Twister.
So what?
So you give him the lead over the
movie. You're more known for being the lead in a great movie. The side guy in a great movie than you are for being the lead in a forgettable popcorn flick. Yes. He is more known for Aliens. I will bet you.
In Star Wars, who's the lead? Han Solo or Luke?
Luke.
Think so?
Yes. Absolutely, 100%.
Not 100%. There's no doubt.
No doubt.
No,
about it.
No.
He's the main
no
character. It's his story. He gets most of the screen time. So
okay.
Well, see how Rich and I lost all of our humor?
Because he did, he made out better than Luke did, and largely because of his role.
Hey, she has a point.
Yeah.
Harrison Ford did not star in Star Wars.
No, but. But we just had the what's he more known for conversation earlier, and it's Indiana Jones.
Sure.
His starring role.
Sure.
In
but if he never made if he never made Indiana Jones,
yeah,
would he be more known for Star Wars or Witness?
Star Wars. Who remembers Witness?
Of course.
Okay, that's the argument. That's the argument.
You know what? Rich wins. Rich wins the argument. Oh, someone got a shakma for that. Star Wars. It happened. You know, it's gonna happen.
Karen has no idea what you're talking about.
Good.
They play a bingo game based on the stream and the things we say and the things we normally talk about.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And like a kind of like a drinking game where it's glugged every time somebody says
yes.
Ooh, here's an important question, Rich.
Yes.
Reb Brown or Robert Zadar?
Robert Zadar. Come on, you can't argue with that face.
Reb Brown. Robert Zadar's face is distracting from his lack of talent, whereas Reb Brown commits 100% to the cheesiest shit. I give it to Reb Brown 100%.
All right.
Reb Brown is all the right man that could have been. And never was.
My answer is Robert Zadar.
All right. Rich and I are getting divorced.
Yes. Finalizing the papers.
I think that would be a great title for a movie, though. The man that could have been.
The man that could have been, but never was.
So when are we going to play head-to-head where you kick my butt or vice versa here? All
right, as soon as you want to start up?
You can finish your round.
Nah, we're going. Get the second controller, Jack. We're going.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
This is going to happen.
Here it is. Here it is.
Thank you, sir. Probably gotta go back one further.
How do we go back? What button does that? There we go.
Okay. Oh, you have to start on the same level. Them's the rules.
What level we start on? We gotta make it more interesting than one.
Oh, here we go. By the way, Cracker Man.
Let's go.
5, 2, 6. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it.
6. I'll go 6. Fine. All right. Start 6.
All right.
Okay. Here's
it's
happening.
Compromise. All the divorce.
You gotta move your thing up.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Okay. Oh my God. It's happening.
Okay.
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 Speed,
wait. Now,
medium.
Rich is the first player.
I think we've been playing on medium.
We'll play medium.
So Rich will be on the left, and Karen is on the right.
Oh, God.
Rich messed up the controls.
That's gonna be fine. Start.
That's totally fine.
I'm on the right.
Yes.
Oh, this is weird. Okay.
Oh, well, you can't handle it?
It's distracting seeing your pieces in the corner of my eye.
Do you surrender?
Not yet. We might get there eventually.
We've played head to head, Dr. Murray.
It's just been
this is nothing
like
new.
10 years.
Yeah. Ah! Oh, and for anyone asking, we are playing this on the Wii U Virtual Console because.
But it's
It's exactly the same game.
Yeah.
It's just an easier way to play it on.
I mean, it
high
looks identical.
Right.
Shit.
Fudge. Oh no! You.
Oh my. Karen gave up.
I didn't give up.
She gave. She straight up gave up.
2 out of 3. 2 out of 3.
Oh yeah.
I forgot it like rains pieces of death down on you when the other person does something good, which means I need to start doing good things faster.
Rich, better start pulling back here.
Here comes the divorce. No,
I respect Karen too much to hold back.
Yeah.
Rich is on the left. Karen is on the right. Rich has one crown over Karen.
Karen.
Those voices to make her adorable. It's no wonder I love you.
Aww.
Rich is using this tactic to distract Karen.
Yeah, I'm sure he is.
What? Is Dr. Mario's Nintendo's answer to Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine? No, this came out well before any sort of Sonic franchise. If Sonic was a competitor to the Super Nintendo, not the regular Nintendo.
I think that might have been a joke.
Is it?
That has to be a joke.
I mean. Oh, we have a stream freeze. We do. Do you guys still hear us, though? I think you still hear us. Hopefully you still hear us. Hold on. Yeah, I see that the stream froze, but can you hear us? This is...
Can you hear me now?
Can you hear us? Oh, yep.
The great answer is no.
The program has failed.
Okay.
But that's okay. I think we're still streaming. Really? Sounds good. Yeah, we're still streaming, but the capture device failed. So
that's weird.
Closing down the capture device. It's very funny how I ask you if you can hear me, and you say, no, we can't hear you. Yeah, I get it. I get it. I'm closing down my Hallpog capture device because it froze.
Brr.
Wilmer, brr.
I'm sorry, what? What?
Don't you know you're Mr. Ed?
I know Mr. Ed. I just can't believe that you brought up Mr. Ed.
What the fuck?
It's never a bad time to bring up Mr. Ed.
Of course.
All right, we are starting the device again.
You bastard.
Actually, it's...
Why do
it's
I
a,
like you?
It's a pretty tight match here.
Charming and wonderful.
It's a pretty tight match. The play-by-play is, oh, Karen's down to 3 viruses and Rich still has 4.
Ah!
Rich keeps raining down nasty pieces that I don't want.
Your nasty pieces end up helping me. That's kind of great.
Yeah, and yours keep on hurting me.
Oh,
I got one more.
Mr. Formanelli, thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. Rich is now down to 1. Oh, Rich. Rich just pulled it out.
That's because of that stupid red thing that came
out.
Okay,
wait. Don't start the next game. I need to unplug something and plug it back in.
So how are you doing, Internet? Is the Internet doing okay today? Oh, they're doing some Dick Neutral stuff.
Ooh, fun.
Dick Neutral is a character we have invented. He is an asexual detective. He's Dick Neutral.
Ah.
Yeah.
So he doesn't have a dick or not
he
have a
dick. He doesn't
get
the sexual innuendos.
Mm. Kind of like the character in Guardians of the Galaxy who doesn't get irony or puns or
metaphors.
Idiomatic. That's it, yeah. Shrek? Never really a fan.
That's the thing. We don't know. We don't get it. They keep trying to bring that up.
Okay.
The stream will be coming back momentarily.
Oh, the chat's bringing up Secret Wars.
Coming soon to a theater near you.
We were talking about Secret Wars earlier. Oh, you're busy putzing around. I'll wait to talk about this to you.
Rich, I'm putzing.
I know.
You need to train the left brain to do this while the right brain...
It doesn't work that way.
Leave me to my putzing. Do-do-do-do-do.
They know I don't like mustard, so they bring up mustard.
Yes, bring it up.
We know how much you love mustard.
You want to tell them the mustard story with the grape upon?
Well, just that I thought that you didn't like mustard because you hadn't had good mustard. You know, I mean, there's a difference between that yellow stuff people put on hot dogs with that real high vinegar count and content and, you know, good Dijon mustard. So I had some good mustard, and... Karen, do you enjoy board games? These questions are starting to remind me of that scene from the movie Airplane. Ever been to a Turkish prison, Billy? But anyway, so I gave him some good Dijon mustard, and no, he's right. It turns out he doesn't like mustard at all.
How long was I gagging?
I'm not sure how long it took you to get the taste, the smell, the thought out of your mouth, but it was a while. You were not happy.
You can also tell them why you call me Chard.
Well... I call him Chard because it's the second half of his name, but also because he accidentally had a little cooking fire some years back when he was much younger and learning how to cook. Yeah. Just kind of set the doorway on fire. I don't know how. Trying to make a grand exit, I guess.
Oh, my God.
Almost burnt down the house?
Yeah, but didn't. Do you ever watch two men wrestle? Ever been to a Turkish prison?
For people coming in late, Karen here is my fiance.
Hi. Again.
And again. And again.
Continuing. Hi.
Hey, guys. I got it back.
Okay.
Yes, always be cool about fire safety. Stop, drop, and roll. Don't screw around with matches. All that good stuff. Don't stick your fork in the electrical socket. Don't put your... Don't take a bath. Yeah, don't take a bath with your curling iron or whatever it is people do.
Okay, so coming back, Rich has 2 victories.
To Cameron's none.
To Cameron's none. But that was a close match. I'm really sorry you guys missed out.
Yeah. All right, we're ready to go.
We're ready to go.
You ready to go?
I am.
All right, we're going.
Even though in a 2 out of 3 world, I've already lost.
Well, that first one was something fluky happened with you, right? I don't know how legit that was.
Okay. Hey.
No, I fucked up.
Hey.
You fucked me up, too, so... I just... Now I'm screwed.
Fuck.
I'm just screwed.
I recently got unscrewed.
How did I get unscrewed?
I said I did.
I got unscrewed. I don't know how.
Oh, well, don't let's just let it happen.
Don't look a gift unscrew in the mouth?
Yes.
Yes, Rich has almost burnt down multiple houses.
At once? There's a name for people who do that.
Who else's house have I accidentally burnt down?
Yeah,
Come on.
I only know about the one.
Isn't this 2? Doesn't this make 2?
No, That's the one. That's my grandmother. That's the one incident.
Yeah.
What happened?
The story you were just telling. Wasn't that number 2?
That's the grandmother. That's the first.
If that's 2, then what's 1? There is that. That's it.
Oh, you're telling the grandmother's house story.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh. So Karen calls Rich charred because...
Also he... because when he was taking some classes there was... some time ago, there was some girls from India or somewhere who used to call him Richard. Which was very cute. Nice girls.
I get it. Richard.
Richard.
Alright, here we go again. Here we go again. This is your chance for redemption, Red.
There is no redemption.
Why not?
No sanctuary.
Yes! Yes, that's a wonderful obscure reference. Logan's Run.
Oh. Okay.
Gotta love Logan's Run.
Logan's Run is a great movie. I agree. It's been a while since I've seen it.
How about The Day the Earth Stood Still? I mean, you gotta love your old cheesy sci-fi movies. Actually, that one's not even cheesy.
See, isn't she perfect?
Turbo Jesus 5000 wants to know if there was a specific point moment that made me give up on Doctor Who, or was it a gradual thing? Karen, did you ever watch Doctor Who?
I've seen a few of them, like the one where Cassandra's all dried out and she's be missed it all the time.
Oh, that's a beautiful one.
Yeah.
That's a beautiful one.
I always mean to, and I never do. I've watched a lot of Red Dwarf. Mm-hmm. I like that. I mean, I do like British humor, but I haven't seen enough to really feel like I should have an opinion on Doctor Who.
I really liked the reboot, or, you know, the new season. It was right after the season with the Silence. There wasn't a specific... episode or moment. It was just the it was, you know who it was? It was Clara. When Clara came in, everything went sour. She was a really bad sidekick or whatever, companion, and the stories got sloppy. The Doctor's character got all weird. It was just a whole thing. Oh my god, they got the Logan's Run reference.
There is no sanctuary. No sanctuary.
Yeah, that's about how he sounds.
I mean, Blink is a beautiful and perfect episode. Blink is a wonderful episode. There are many really wonderful episodes of Doctor Who. It just got really sloppy. Like the episode where the Doctor is in an old Western town and suddenly decides he wants to murder someone for no particular reason. Because the Doctor doesn't murder people, but that's fine.
Wait, the Doctor tries to murder somebody for no reason?
For no reason whatsoever. He decides out of the blue that he needs to murder someone. And then halfway through he's like, I guess I don't want to murder him. And tries to figure out a way to not murder him.
Sounds like it doesn't make any sense.
No, the characterization got super fucked up.
Taking acid while they were writing the scripts or something?
Yeah, it's just a bad writer, and the person who was writing it was also show running, and so they just
he got away with whatever.
He got Lucas'd. He had no one to tell him no. and the show went to shit, and that's fine.
So when did this happen?
Oh, not till like season 8 of the reboot.
Okay.
So there were 7 or 8, I forget which season The Silence was, but there were many, many quality seasons. But just got fucked up.
At quality discount prices?
At quality discount prices, because they're all on Netflix. So, which is really why I started watching it. I just needed a new show, and I knew there were so much of them.
Speaking of salesmen, do you remember when...
The mattress store? I was just thinking about that recently.
We tried to buy a mattress once, and it was the most miserable experience you could have, trying to buy anything.
If you don't buy it in the next 30 seconds, you're going to die. You need to buy it now.
We were in the store for like literally a minute, and this guy's already putting on the pressure.
Yeah, there's no... I was going to win this one. I was so close. Sitting here, whittling away in my virus pile, and then all of a sudden, you clear your stage. Getting closer. What's that?
That was a close one.
Will Karen say my name? It will make my day. Jack Trigger Joyce.
And there you have it, folks! Yeah.
What?
Somebody wanted Karen to say his name.
Jack Trigger name, Joyce. There's twice.
There you go.
Am I playing?
Okay, all right.
This was your effort to get me distracted here. Now I'm losing another round.
You know what? I'm gonna let 2 pills just go by unnoticed. There you go.
Oh.
That's okay, because
what?
I was already doomed.
Oh, come on!
No. Let's
Karen gave
start.
Up.
Yeah. Because I was screwed.
That's not the right attitude.
Fan interference! Fan interference!
Fight on, even if it's completely hopeless and you're doomed to failure.
The drug wasn't working.
So you know what you need to do? Shove more pills down there.
Mario does not have a healthy relationship with substances.
Mushrooms, pills.
Driving under the influence.
Right.
Oh, stop giving me blue and red when I got everything is yellow. Yellow as far as the eye can see. Yellow up the ass and keep sending me red and blue pills. Oh no, I fucked that up.
You've heard it here first, folks. Rich has yellow up the ass. Butt jokes. They're my favorite.
I know they are.
It's okay, Jack. We're an accepting bunch.
Accepting butt jokes.
Accepting bunch?
a bunch of butt jokes.
And accepting butch?
Ooh, butch jokes. I don't know too many butch jokes.
What?
What?
The blue thing is on top of my...
You're doing better than I am.
I'm too busy doing what I'm doing to look at you.
Ooh, old yeller. Old yellow up the butt. I like it.
Yeah,
something.
If there was ever a movie that was designed to manipulate your emotions, that is it.
Old yeller?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Classic killing a dog movie. Beautiful. the old movie genre, killing the dog? Yeah.
You need to set it to some kind of music or something. We have... I've seen in some supermarkets a brand of dog food called Old Yeller, and I always see it and I think, so that's what they did after they capped his ass. Turned him into Old Yeller dog food.
Ooh, nice.
I just don't know how to clear this over here.
Oh, you're in a pickle, aren't you?
I am in a pickle. I gotta try to clear those from underneath.
I have not checked out Ghost in the Shell Arise. You know what I did do, though? Because there was so much anime talk last stream, I finally looked
into... You decided never to watch anime again?
No, I've had this thing, Attack on Titan. Have you heard of that?
No.
It's an anime I see around the internet all the time. I thought it was a movie, but apparently it's a series. And I've been watching... last night, just out of the blue, I started watching Attack on Titan. All of a sudden, it's 1 a.m, and I've seen like 10 episodes. It's great. Attack on Titan is really beautiful.
So what's that about?
It's about these horrendous giant people-looking monsters that eat people.
Uh-huh.
And the town, all of the world is walled off, and they keep getting in. And it's about the people who fight the giant titans, and it's great. And
okay.
It's, you know.
Okay.
I don't actually know much about it. I'm only 10 episodes in, and so it's, you know, it's just about the people that fight the titans, and they have these like mechanical Spider-Man belts that like grapple hook, and they can float around like Spider-Man. It's really great. So I've been really, yeah. It's about naked. It's about giant naked cannibals. All the titans are naked, but they look like people. But they kind of look like dim-witted people with giant smiles on their face. And so then when they like eat people and blood gushes everywhere, it's really creepy.
It certainly sounds like anime.
Yeah, it's really beautiful. It's really, really beautiful. I liked the first Ghost in the Shell movie. We talked about that. I saw that in the theaters. I have seen anime in the past, but it's been a while. It's nice. I need to review some bad anime. No, I'm fine.
Oh, I got one more. I didn't know.
Oh my god, what is... Karen, what did you do? All of your pills.
She ended up in a pickle.
That's a real pickle. Oh my god. Yeah.
I know.
I was doing a pretty good job of getting it from underneath.
I feel bad because you were doing a pretty good job. One more time.
I mean, when you're trying to, you know, take out stalactites.
Dongitly, I was talking about Man and... What was it called again? Man in the Castle? You guys don't know.
No.
The Amazon series, the Philip K. Dick series, right. Man in the Castle, something, Men in... Someone remember what I said earlier and type it.
Something castle.
Something in the castle.
I thought it was Man in the Castle.
The men who live in castles is the Amazon pilot season. Someone's gonna say it.
Men who live in castles shouldn't stow thrones.
The Man in the High Castle.
What did I do?
That's what it's called, and it's great. So if you have Amazon Prime,
I got fucked.
Go to pilot
season.
Me
to win.
No, I got fucked. I got fucked. I did not give that to you. I got fucked.
Then you have to go to.
You won.
Amazon Prime.
You won.
Season.
What the fuck?
I'm
not fucking.
And vote for it. So it can get made.
So what's up, Jack? What do you want to talk about, Jack?
I'm just talking. Just talking to Jack. This is good. I think this is good. I think this is good. I've been playing crappy video games all day, so it's fun watching a good video game.
See, we're not reviewing Call of Duty, though. It's gonna come up, but...
Oh, no, like I said, that's just for me. That's just like a general... I usually make fun of Call of Duty.
Yeah.
And I haven't played one in a while, so now I feel like I have all the right in the world to make fun of Call of Duty again.
Okay.
I've re-upped my Call of Duty.
Your subscription?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, we're even. We're even. Your goose is not cooked yet.
I know Dr. Killed a Cat, and that's fine. I'm just gonna talk to myself. While Rich and Karen.
You know, what do you want? We can talk about anything you want.
Oh, no.
What do you want?
That's just the joke.
Fucker.
Ooh, RLM reference. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. Rich, have you played any regular Far Cry 3 or just Blood Dragon?
I played a little bit of regular. I am having trouble getting into it.
Mm-hmm. Just because it's not as awesome as Blood Dragon?
Basically, yes. in general, it's just not as fun.
Mm-hmm. I suppose going from the like 80s techno,
yeah,
like 80s rock
to kind of
hyper
a bland
light
jungle,
right? That'd be a rough transition. I have not seen Tusk yet.
Shit.
Mr. Forminelli. And I don't plan on it. Even though Jay said he loved it, Jay said he loved it because of how bad it was.
Oh, what did I do?
And I don't know if it's that bad for me to actually like it.
Don't give up. Don't give up. You're
never give up. Never surrender.
Still ahead of me.
You're the best of the best.
You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever.
Oh my god.
No, keep going.
Karate Kid.
You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. Odd Mutation, if someone subscribes with a really horrific name, would you still say it?
Not if it was well, like no. Total.
There are limits.
There are limits. There are 100% limits, but your example of cunt butterbuckle, I would definitely say that. That is not the limit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If we really didn't like your name, we might just make something up.
Yeah.
But you're...
It's not personally offensive to any group or individual.
It's just
kind of blandly tasteless. Which is a lesser sin.
Being tasteless is a lesser sin? Sure.
But yes.
You know how I might handle that?
Hmm.
I might say, "You're an asshole! Thank you for subscribing!"
Right? Oh no, I've opened the floodgates. Well, you know what? If that's what you feel like spending your $5 on, if you feel like spending your $5 on seeing what we'll say, I'm more than okay with that. But, you know, I can't imagine.
I don't care what I'm saying.
So am I.
I want
to play something? Go on, Mark.
Go on, Mark.
Here you go.
I've been playing Mario nonstop for like forever here.
We can be done with Mario soon. We've been playing Mario for like an hour.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, longer than that, but no. Play as long as you want. We're just talking and playing games. That's what we do.
Yeah.
Talk about TV series? Or
yeah.
Well, you know, watch
The Librarians at all?
Librarians?
No.
It's cheesy as hell.
What is this one again? You've mentioned it before.
It's a... How would I even describe it? It's these people who... It's based on a couple of movies that they had, which were probably straight to video.
Mm.
And these people are like librarians, and they run around trying to gather all the magic in the world back in. But it's just... It's got some fun cheesy episodes. Like one episode, I was so bad at playing this and talking at the same time. they find this house that it's like a haunted house that eats people, and mm-hmm. It's been traveling through time and showing up different places for
the
years.
The house travels through time?
Yeah, in their library. I can't even describe it, but it's a fun show. It doesn't always make sense. It's frequently very silly.
Mm-hmm.
You would probably like rip it apart critically.
Sure.
I don't doubt. But it's whimsical and fun.
Mm-hmm.
We like whimsical.
Whimsical.
Yeah. I've also been enjoying Gotham.
Rich was saying he was liking Gotham as well.
You're gonna have to defend that because the people don't like Gotham.
Because it's not mostly about Batman?
You'll have to have that discussion with the chat when somebody else starts playing. I'm sure this will come up a lot. These people have very strong opinions on Gotham.
Okay.
That's the worst thing ever.
Well, they're all entitled to my opinion. No. kidding.
I think that's an oh snap.
Nice.
Oh shoot. Shoot.
Now you're on the trolley. All right, Jack, you want to play this for a bit? Or do you want to play something else?
I'm going to play a different
Jack
game.
Versus Rich,
okay.
Cuz
no, I'll lose.
Rich clearly.
I'll lose. You know what I'm going to play?
Oh.
I'm going to play some Metroid.
I'm rusty and Rich is like